Now these are the applications or examples of those that where the pattern recognition is important. This is handwritten document. Now how you can convert this handwritten document into the in the text document, okay, which could be edited or which the different text processing operations can be done upon. Okay, you are converting this handwritten document into a Word document in which you can perform word processing operations. You can delete something or whatever operation you want, you can perform those operations on this document. Example is character recognition. Okay, so by the from the character recognition, you can convert the handwritten document into the digital document. Okay? These are the fingerprint images. These images can also be used to identify an individual, or these images can also be categorized. For example, a machine should be able to tell whether this is a right loop, whether this is a left loop. So your application should be such that it takes this image as an input and produce the category of the output, whether that input was plain arch or tented arch, or in which category that image was falling. So this is another application of the pattern recognition. Now, next slide is of biometric applications. Okay, so these are all biometric applications of pattern recognition. Self-driving car, you can call. Okay, so these are self-driving cars.
Anyone? Sir, basically incoming traffic, sir.
Incoming traffic. The images of incoming traffic can be analyzed, and then decision can be made about how to turn steering or how to apply brake. Cancer detection. In medical field also, pattern recognition is and machine learning is widely used. Okay, so there are different types of cells which can be analyzed and categorized whether the person or the patient is affected by the disease or not. This is land cover classification using satellite data. Okay, so these are satellite images, and these images can also be categorized for different types of analysis, and land can be classified whether this land would come in a greenery area or it will be dot or what.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So next is the sorting incoming fish on a conveyor belt. This is a problem, and this problem can be seen as a pattern recognition problem, and you will understand the concepts of pattern recognition by just going through this problem. So what is this problem? Sorting incoming fish on a conveyor belt according to the species. Okay, now assume that we have only two kinds of fish, sea bass and salmon. Okay, so there are two kinds of fish, sea bass and salmon. So whichever fish coming on the conveyor belt, that fish should be recognized by the, should be packed in different boxes. Okay, sea bass should be packed in one box and salmon should be packed in other box. So it should be classified. Now, what kind of information can distinguish one species from the other? These are the features or parameters or characteristics which can be acquired from a fish. For example, length, width, weight, number and shape of fins, tail shape, etc. So these are some characteristics which can be measured or which can be acquired from a fish. Now, what can cause problem during sensing? Sensing means taking input. Okay, so that input can be taken by a camera, with the help of a camera, as you are doing in this example, or that input can be taken by a microphone, as in the case of in voice recognition or other applications of sound recognition. Okay, but here you are taking images of the fish, so the sensing device here is a camera. Okay, so what can cause problem during sensing? Lighting conditions. In different lighting conditions, the same object can look differently, and it can be misclassified. Now, position of fish is another problem. So fish, not necessary that fish is aligned in a particular direction. So you have to take image of the fish, and then you have to perform rotation of that image so that all the images are aligned one another, so that the classification can be done. Next is camera noise. Different types of camera noise, it can include the electronic humming or other type of noises can also be considered in this category. Now, what are the steps in the process? Capture image. First, you will capture the image. Then you will isolate fish. What is meant by isolate fish? isolate fish means capturing the image of fish and just removing the background. Okay, take measurement. Measurement means you want to measure the characteristics like length, width, weight, and number and shapes of fins. So this is taking measurement, means quantifying the characteristics of the fish. After that, you will make the decision. So this is the entire process. Now, assume a fisherman told us that a sea bass is generally longer than a salmon. This is a general concept of a fisherman. Now, we can use length as a feature and decide between sea bass and salmon according to the threshold on length. Okay. Now, how can we choose this threshold? This is important. So what is this graph? This graph is actually a histogram. And what this graph is showing? This graph is saying that on x-axis you have a length and on y-axis you have a count. Okay. So what it is saying? It is saying that in a lot of the fish, you have 16 fish of length 5 or 5 centimeter, whatever unit you are considering here. Similarly, you have 12 fish of this particular length. So this is a graph which is showing the frequency of different kinds of fish on the basis of length. So here only you are only considering one feature, that is length. So when you are considering this length, you have drawn this graph. So now in this graph, you can see that although most of the fish of length less than 10 are of salmon category. Okay. जैसा कि हमारे फिशरमैन ने बताया था, फिशरमैन ने बोला था कि लेंथ उसकी जो सैल्मन की होती है वो जनरली कम होती है. तो जो हमारे पास जो बॉक्स था, जो लॉट थी, उस लॉट में भी हमने ये देखा कि जो भी लेंथ 10 से कम की फिश थी उनकी कैटेगरी सैल्मन की ही थी. सिमिलरली दिस इज द कैटेगरी फॉर सी बास. ओके, सो हेयर यू कैन सी दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द फिश वेयर द लेंथ इज ग्रेटर देन 10 are sea bass. So although most of the things are correctly classified or most of the observations are correct according to the fisherman's concept, but there are some exceptions also as well. So there are lots of fish having length less than 10 which are in salmon category. We can say that this is according to our correct concept, but here you can see that there are exceptions. There are some fish which are not according to the fisherman's concept. So you can see exceptions here in salmon category, and you can also see the exceptions in the sea bass category. So I just want you to understand perfectly this graph. Is there any problem in the graph?
No, sir.
We have only taken one feature which is called length. Okay. Next is, even though sea bass is longer than salmon on the average, there are many examples of fish where this observation does not hold. Okay, as you can see in the previous graph, there are many observations which are not holding good. Try another feature. Now adding average lightness of the fish, ki koi color kitni bright hai ya white hai aur kitni black hai. So now this is according to the lightness. Okay, the same graph according to the lightness, not according to the length. Okay, so here you can see there are exceptions. You are getting here also there are some exceptions, but there are less number of exceptions as compared to the previous graph. Okay, so what you can say about these two features? What you can say about length and the lightness? You can easily say that lightness in this particular case you can easily say that the lightness is a better feature than the length. Is it clear?
Yes sir.
Fish ko classify aap kar rahe ho, और सपोज जो सैल्मन है वो डार्क कलर की होती है और सी बास ब्राइट कलर की होती है. फिशरमैन ने हमें ये बताया कि जो सैल्मन टाइप की फिश होती है वो डार्क कलर की होती है और जो सी बास टाइप की फिश होती है वो ब्राइट कलर की होती है. ठीक है, तो इसमें ये एक्सेप्शंस ज्यादा इसलिए. अच्छा, फिशरमैन ने हमें ये भी बताया कि जो सैल्मन फिश होती है उसकी लेंथ कम होती है और जो सी बास फिश होती है उसकी लेंथ ज्यादा होती है. लेकिन यहां पर हमें ज्यादा एक्सेप्शंस इसलिए मिल रहे हैं क्योंकि जो भी आपने फिशिंग की है और जो आपके पास लॉट है अवेलेबल, उस लॉट में हो सकता है कि कुछ बेबी सी बास फिश भी हो. तो जो बेबी सी बास फिश होंगी तो उनकी लेंथ, उसकी जो लेंथ होगी वो कम होगी.
ओके,
दैट्स व्हाई यू आर सीइंग हियर द एक्सेप्शंस. उसने हमें जो बताया था लेंथ का कॉन्सेप्ट, वो लेंथ का कॉन्सेप्ट एक एडल्ट फिश के बारे में बताया था, तो वो बेबी फिश के बारे में फेल हो गया, है ना. तो इसलिए यहाँ पर आपके एक्सेप्शंस ज्यादा हैं. यहाँ पर एक्सेप्शंस कम क्यों मिल रहे हैं, क्योंकि फिश चाहे, अगर हम लेंथ लाइटनेस कंसीडर कर रहे हैं, तो फिश चाहे वो सेलमन हो या चाहे वो सीबास हो, कोई सी भी फिश हो, उसकी लाइटिंग पर, लाइटनेस पर ज्यादा फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. अगर वो ब्राइट होगी तो थ्रू आउट द लाइफ वो ब्राइट रहेगी, और अगर वो डार्क होगी तो थ्रू आउट द लाइफ वो डार्क रहेगी. Okay, so that's why you are seeing here the less number of exceptions. And because there are less number of exceptions, we can say that the lightness is a better feature than the length. Customer who buy sea bass will not be unhappy if they occasionally see some expensive salmon in the can. Okay, so cost of error means ki what will happen if error occurs. Okay, this will also be considered while making decision, that what is the cost of error. जैसे अभी हमने कोविड 19 में देखा, एक गन टाइप की डिवाइस थी, उस गन से वो थर्मल स्कैनिंग कर रहे थे. सो दैट थर्मल स्कैनिंग क्या बता रही थी वो, क्या वो ये बता रही थी कि दैट पर्सन इज कोरोना अफेक्टेड? नो, इट वाज जस्ट टेलिंग, इट वाज जस्ट टेलिंग वेदर द टेम्परेचर इज राइज्ड और नॉट, वेदर द पर्सन इज हैविंग हाई टेम्परेचर और नॉट. But if the person is having high temperature, it does not mean that the person is affected by corona. Okay, the temperature can be raised because of various reasons. The entry on a particular place was restricted on the basis of that scanning, because the cost of error was very high. Cost of error was very high. कि अगर कोई suspect अंदर पहुंच गया और अगर उसे corona निकला, तो उसकी cost क्या है? ठीक है. और अगर वो person सस्पेक्ट नहीं निकला और अगर उसे कोरोना नहीं हुआ, दो चीजें हो सकती हैं इसमें, ध्यान दो मेरी बात पे, इसमें दो चीजें हो सकती हैं. किसी को हमने टेस्ट किया, तो वो टेस्ट मशीन ने अगर पॉजिटिव बताया, तो दो केस हो सकते हैं, या तो वाकई उसे कोरोना हो सकता है या उसे कोरोना नहीं हो सकता है. ठीक है, लेकिन यहां पर कॉस्ट ऑफ एरर क्या है? कॉस्ट ऑफ एरर बहुत ज्यादा इसलिए है बिकॉज इफ अ पर्सन गेट्स एंट्री इन टू एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, इन टू ए बिल्डिंग, दैट वुड बी वेरी हाई कॉस्ट incurred on the other individuals which present in the building. अगर उसे कोरोना है तब तो ठीक हुआ है, मतलब decision was correct. लेकिन अगर उसे कोरोना नहीं था तो भी हमने उसे रोका, तो हमने क्या किया, loss of the work, जो वो काम करता किसी organization में, वो loss of work. तो now you have to compromise or you have to compare the loss of the work or loss due to the corona. These two, or you have to compare these two things, and then you have to make decision. So here the cost of the wrong decision was very high. Ki we can check most of the suspect out of the building at this time because that is very serious or very dangerous disease. So iska matlab kya hua ki chahe corona ho ya na ho, agar koi jara sa suspect bhi lag raha hai to use bhi entry mat do, because the cost of error is very high. Okay, so this is called cost of the error. For example, if the fish packing company knows that customer who buy salmon will object vigorously if they see sea bass in the can. Jaise aap suppose ek company hai jisme ki gold aur silver ki packing ho rahi hai. Theek hai. Ab agar aap silver ko galat, ab ye kyunki different types ke materials hain aur cost mein bahut zyada different hai silver aur gold mein. To agar ye ek dusre ke packets mein pack ho jate hain, agar silver gold wale packet mein pack ho jata hai, तो दिस इज अ बिग लॉस फॉर द कस्टमर. और अगर गोल्ड सिल्वर वाले पैकेट में पैक हो जाता है, तो दिस इज अ बिग लॉस फॉर द पैकर. ओके, द स्पेशलिस्ट. लेकिन अगर सपोज हम बात कर रहे हैं कि सपोज एल्युमिनियम एंड आयरन, सपोज वी आर पैकिंग दीज टू टाइप्स ऑफ मटेरियल्स और मेटल्स, नाउ देयर विल बी लेस कॉस्ट ऑफ एरर. तो एल्युमिनियम वाले पैक में अगर थोड़ा सा आयरन चला जाए, या एक आयरन का पीस चला जाए, या आयरन वाले पैक में एल्युमिनियम पीस चला जाए, तो कॉस्ट ऑफ एरर यहां पर कम है. तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि गोल्ड सिल्वर के केस में कॉस्ट ऑफ एरर बहुत ज्यादा है, और एल्युमिनियम और आयरन के केस में कॉस्ट ऑफ एरर कम है. तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ, यू शुड बी वेरी केयरफुल व्हेन यू आर डीलिंग विद द गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर. While reducing error, you have to input, there would be the cost of the development of the system also. तो जब आप कोई सिस्टम डेवलप कर रहे हैं उसमें भी कॉस्ट होगा. तो हाउ सेंसिटिव सिस्टम यू वांट टू मेक. नाउ अज्यूम वी ऑब्जर्व दैट सी वास आर टिपिकली वाइडर देन सैल्मन. सो हेयर वी हैव कंसीडर्ड वन मोर फीचर हेयर, ओके, वाइडर देन द सैल्मन. नाउ वी कैन यूज टू फीचर्स इन आवर डिसीजन, लाइटनेस एंड विड्थ. तो अगर हम इन दोनों को कंसिडर करें एक साथ, सो नाउ द ईच फिश इमेज इज नाउ रिप्रेजेंट एज अ पॉइंट इन अ टू डायमेंशनल स्पेस एंड दैट स्पेस इज कॉल्ड फीचर स्पेस. नाउ जस्ट लुक हेयर, यू कैन सी दैट ऑन एक्स एक्सिस द लाइटनेस इज बींग रिप्रेजेंटेड एंड ऑन वाई एक्सिस यू आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग द विड्थ. यू हैव टू फाइंड अ लाइन इन दिस स्पेस सच दैट द मैक्सिमम फिश आर करेक्टली क्लासिफाइड. इज इट क्लियर? तो आपने क्या कि इस पूरे स्पेस में सारी फिश ड्रॉ कर दी जो अभी आपके पास फिश थी. नाउ यू हैव टू फाइंड अ लाइन एन इक्वेशन ऑफ लाइन व्हिच कैन करेक्टली क्लासिफाई द टू टाइप्स ऑफ फिश. ओके, सो नाउ दिस लाइन वुड बिकम द क्लासिफायर. दिस क्लासिफायर इज कॉल्ड लिनियर क्लासिफायर. एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर नाउ टिल दिस पॉइंट?
यस सर.